Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Bloodborne. I'm Miranda Bahamut, and last time we killed the Cleric Beast and Father Gascon, so today we are entering the Cathedral Ward and whips up past the right tombstone. So let's jump on in. Right back into the graveyard where we fought Gascon. At least I think that's how his name is pronounced. Don't quote me on it. I'm just guessing. And there's the gate that would be completely closed until we actually kill Gascon. Not sure why they made him drop a key to open that gate when we could just open it normally, since they don't normally let you leave boss arenas anyway. And here's the red jewel brooch that the little girl was asking us to find on her dead mother there. Isn't that just lovely? Basically, at the end of this little fetch quest, we get both her and her little sister killed. Well, maybe older sister, whatever. In order to get ribbons to dress up our messengers a bit more. Yeah, I don't know if it's worth it either. Man, there's a lot of caskets going on down here. Well, maybe these priests are just buying in bulk because they know it's the night of the hunt. Now, Lord knows I'm building up a body count. Should also note I bought the Chief Hunter Emblem thingamabdealy from the store between videos. See, the Bergenworth spider hides all manner of rituals and keeps our lost master from us. A terrible shame, it makes my head shudder uncontrollably. That's actually referencing a boss that we'll be fighting quite a bit later in the forest. Pretty sure everyone knows which one that is. And odds are, I will completely forget about it by the time forget about that note by the time it actually becomes relevant. Well, it is pretty. Not sure what we're supposed to be seeing here. That's kind of freaky. And I see something on the right. Well, that was on the right a second ago. We're in the cathedral. Hello there.
Oh, you must be a hunter. Very sorry. The incense must have masked your sin. Good, good. I've been waiting for one of your ilk.
Hey.
These hunts have everyone all locked up inside. Waiting for it to end. It always does. Always has, you know. Since forever. But it won't end nicely. Not this time. Even some folks hiding inside are going bad. The screams of women folk. The stench of blood. The snarls of beasts, none of them's too uncommon now.
I have seen quite a bit of all of that since I've gotten here.
But if you spot anyone with their wits about them, tell them about this here Erden Chapel. They'll be safe here. The incense wards off the beasts. Spread the word. Tell them to come on over. If you wouldn't mind.
So we've found our first sanctuary. And as odd-looking as this dude is, he's actually probably the nicest NPC in the game. I know, shocker, right? There's also a very interesting and rather unique death. Well, I wouldn't say unique since it can happen later, but anyway, that we can get in a second. Ah, dang it. Yeah, the clergy here are actually pretty easy to riposte on their little kind of stab thing they do with their staves. Whoa, hello there. Ah, dang it. Because they have quite a bit of a wind-up on most of the... dang it. I'm completely screwing this up. Oh, you gotta make me look bad, man. That's what you get. And Quicksilver bullets! Hey, fully replenished all the bullets I dropped. Oh well. Not gonna complain. And hey, whole set of Hunter's Garb, and oh god, what is this? Oh my, there seems to be something fairly invisible just crushing me. Well, that went poorly. So yeah, if you stand around too much in this general area, well, you just saw what happened. So if you see a strange whirly wind of black hole things, get away from it. Now before I forget, there's actually two sets of safe havens, I guess is what you'd call them. This is our first one, and I'll warp us over to our second. So back to good old Central Yharnam teleporting. There's actually a closer one to where we're going, but I wanted to go do this first.
You needn't concern yourself with me.
You sound pretty sick, dude.
I'm afraid I'm of little help now. But before I did this...
Well, thank you.
No use of it, but perhaps you... What afflicted me was incurable. But this time gave me hope. Their strange blood bought me time. I was most fortunate, unharmed by the plague of beasts. I can even die human.
No, you won't. Spoiler alert. Anyway, as my cake kind of, well, coke kind of fleets out there. Dang it, bullets. I want more blood vials. I'm actually not that carrying all that many. I haven't done much in the way of grinding or any shape or form, so I'm only relying on stuff that drops. So yes, we're returning back to Yosefska's clinic. Dang it, why are my words not working well? In all honesty, I could have come back here earlier and talked to her before and gotten a blood vial from her, but it's kind of finicky to use. Anyway, it's just...
Oh, well, hello.
I'm fist-pumping at you.
Splendid. Let me ask you a small kindness. You're soon off to hunt, I presume? Then, if you find any survivors, tell them to seek Yosefka's clinic. Upon my Hippocratic oath, if they are yet human, I will look after them. Perhaps even cure them. This sickness, these beasts, they are not to be feared. This time the night is long. I may be trapped here, but I should do something to help. I'll even offer a reward for your cooperation. Tempted?
Perhaps.
Well, off you go then.
Yeah, and while she was talking, I was trying to finagle the camera so we can actually kind of, like, see her. Can kind of see, like, her ear there a bit in the corner, and there's some of her face. But, yeah, that's the Yosefka. Oh, whoops. Didn't mean to do that again. Expect me to randomly fist pump all over the place as I hit X at times. So, yes, we have two places we can now send people, like the old lady we ran into earlier. We can send her to the Cathedral Ward or to Yosefka's clinic. Although this, well, I'm gonna put it this way. You're only gonna ever send people to Yosefka's once. Because she's actually kind of evil. Or whoever that is, because that's actually a fake Yosefka. She even has a different voice actress compared to when you run into her earlier. Well, we could have ran into her earlier, but I kind of screwed that up. Anyway, as you might imagine, we're currently heading off to the little old lady to see if we can send her to the cathedral.
Hey.
Thank you for the bullets. As I recall, she's just passed over the bridge down here. Well, the doggies. There's the loose one. So! Oh, there's one. Yep, right here. You foos ain't gonna catch me off guard. Cause I remember things!
Shutting up indoors isn't always enough. Well, if you weren't as got off your arses, you wouldn't be in this mess.
Yeah, I just got here, lady. And I've already killed two huge ones.
So what will it be? Are you going to tell me you're not?
So yeah, the wait on chapel or Yosefka's clinic.
Well, what do you know?
Not sure why I kind of praise the sun there.
Well, don't just that. Don't you have work? Go slit some throats.
Because shit in this game is gonna get worse way before it gets better. And oh, I missed you, apparently. Oh well. Although I swear spending that 10,000 soul, not souls, blood echoes on the chief emblem, chief hunter's emblem, that's it. Always feels like a knife in the back. Just for how many echoes it is for this early in the game. That's like 4 to 5 level ups almost. Anyway, let's head back to Oedon's Cathedral. Oh, and see, here she is.
Nona, I haven't forgotten. Do you think I owe you something?
Maybe.
Well, that's a fine lark, I'd say. This whole mess that Yharnam's in, it's all your fault. You put it to the outside.
Oh, no, it isn't, lady. I know what's going on.
Tainted by your ilk.
Ha!
You come near me. I know your type.
Do you even know what your blood ministration shit is, lady? Also, hi there, priest dude. Whoa. Soul! Or blood echoes. Whatever. Kinda wish they kept it as souls. It's easier to say than blood echoes. And hi there. Oh, he got my souls from when I died to the... I don't want to give it its name yet, but from the invisible thing that's hanging out right over there. Thing is, if I actually got enough insight, we could actually see the thing. And it's rather freaky. Gotta love the architecture around here. It all looks very, very pretty. Crap. This is another area that can kinda get... Oh, I don't know how to put it. Clusterfucky? Basically, if you aggro these guys wrong, you can get your shit right real quick. Like you wouldn't believe, man. I mean, I have been pretty much been making the villagers be a complete joke throughout all this. But they are actually capable of some pretty good damage. Especially the torch-wielding dudes. And the torch attacks just comes right out of nowhere at times, so it's very hard to properly dodge it, I guess I'd say. Hey, more flamey bombies. Molotovs do drop off quite a... Oh, wait, I don't want to go in here yet. Molotovs do drop off pretty quickly in terms of damage. But they are still handy to have. Also, hi there. Yeah, this is a bit of a dick move, too. You got a sniper up there with two dogs who just, you can't see once you, start. Yeah, bad doggy. No biscuit. Sup, dude? The Lord knows I want to shoot the hell out of someone who just killed my dogs. Cause that ain't right, man. Admittedly, his dogs are rabid mongrels that want to rip my throat out and eat me, but still. And we have a new friend to make down here.
You're a beast hunter, aren't you?
Apparently, yes.
That's precisely how I started out. Oh, beg pardon. You may call me Alfred.
Okay.
Protégé of Master Ligarius, hunter of vile bloods. So, what say you? Our prey might differ, but we are hunters, the both of us.
Do you think you could actually look at me when you're talking to me?
And discuss the things we've learned.
Okay.
Oh, very good. Very good indeed. Take this to celebrate our acquaintance.
Yay!
Beast hunting is a sacred
practice. I didn't plan on doing that, but whatever.
Good blood guide your way. There must be... Go on. Just tell me what piqued...
Yeah, I skipped his dialogue. There's just basically, oh, you want to hear something? What do you want to hear?
As you know, the Healing Church is the fountainhead of...
Blood. If I knew, why are you telling me?
I'm a simple hunter, quite unfamiliar with the ins and outs of the institution. But I have heard that the holy medium of blood healing is venerated in the main cathedral.
And we'll be killing it later.
The counselors of the old church reside in the high stratum of the cathedral ward. If you seek blood healing, and the church is willing, you should pay them a visit.
I kind of think they won't be receiving many visitors at this time.
Bergenworth is an old place of learning.
You don't know what the fuck.
Carved out below Yharnam should be familiar to every hunter. Well, once a group of young Bergenworth scholars discovered a holy medium deep within the tomb. This led to the founding of the Healing Church and the establishment of blood healing. In this sense, everything sacred in Yharnam can be traced back to Bergenworth. But today, the college lies deep within a tangled wood, abandoned and decrepit. And furthermore, the Healing Church has declared Bergenworth forbidden ground. It's unclear how many of its scholars remain alive, but only they know the password that allows passage through the gate. I bid you farewell. May the good...
So Bergenworth is kind of our goal at the moment. I mean, it's not really explicit on go here to do stuff, but that's basically where we're supposed to be heading is Bergenworth. Unfortunately, if we try to now, there's a door in the way and we're asked if we know what the password, but we don't. So we gotta, whoa, hi there. You gotta kill the boss of the area in order to get said password. I did say that right? And I need to stop celebrating. Holy crap, I'm in the middle of a blood-soaked, monster-filled nightmare, and I'm just as happy as can be. Oh, we got our first blood gem. Blood gems are, well, basically upgrades for our weapons. We could stick them in slots, and hi there! You put them in slots, and it gives our weapons new effects. Each weapon can hold 3, but they all have different shapes to their slots, I guess is the way I put it. Dang it! Hey, I needed another one of those to +2 my sock lever. So, success. Whee! That's where the physics on my coat always make me laugh. Is there? Yes, there is something here. Antidotes. And hey, found ourselves another lantern. Mainly because we've actually found the... I guess the best way to put it is the side area for this whole place. My god, these are some heavy doors. So yeah, welcome to Old Yharnam. I kind of lied. We're actually going through here before we go through the Cathedral Ward. Now, first thing we gotta do, drop down here, grab this, and try to kill that sucker! Oh. Well, that was a fail. Well, probably next time I come around here, it'll be a lot easier to take out since it's already done its vanish. Well, I've already picked up the blood shard that was right there. So, let's see. You gotta really be careful in this area, too, because guys like to hide in those little alcoves. Sup? So these are the... Whoa! Hi there. These are the patients. They're fairly easy to recognize, and they're not that tough. They do have a spaz flip-out attack that can do some damage, but in general they're pretty slow, so it's not that hard to get away. It doesn't look like we're done dropping. Always be careful when dropping down and confirm where you're gonna land. Because there's certainly fall damage in this game and it hurts. Even more ladder climbing action. Do I need to queue up Metal Gear Solid 3's theme song? Because this game has some big ass ladders. And even more cold blood dew.
You there? Hunter! Didn't you see the warning?
Yes, I did.
Turn back at once.
Nah.
Old Yharnam, burned and abandoned by men, is now home only to beasts. They are of no harm. Turn back, or the hunter will face the hunt.
Oh, really? Dang it, stop doing that! Especially when we're surrounded by these guys. Yeah, I nicknamed those guys the Gremlins. They're a lot like the other patient guys, but... they're not that bad to either. Whoa, hi there. Ow. Crap. That's both of them dead. Yep, patient. Apparently she managed to wing me at some point. I didn't exactly see it connect, though. I could tell because my little poison meter showed up. And I guess I didn't really explain poison. So, yeah, there's poison in this game. Duh. Whoa. There. Basically, the way it works, well, you saw that little meter there. When a poisonous attack hits, the meter starts to fill. And when it maxes out, then, well, your poison it starts to slowly drain. Once it fully drains, then you're out of poison. Well, I should say cured. Obviously, it's fairly important to, well, get it cured because you don't want to deal with damage over time.
You're a skilled hunter. Adept. Merciless. I've got to admit.
And we can actually see our little friend that's talking to us. He's way up there on top of that clock tower. You can kind of see the little gun establishment that he has. Gun emplacement, that's it. And we're also not going to like his little gun emplacement in a little bit. Because I imagine you're already seeing where this is going, judging from how I just talked about him. Because he's kind of a dick. Whoa! And there's a reason why I'm trying to lure these guys back here. Because bad things will happen if I try to engage them out in the open there. I don't see any real things to pick up around here.
Which is why I must stop you.
Yep, here we go. Woo! So yeah, dude has a Gatling gun up there. I'm trying to remember the actual route down there. Oh, here we go. So this entire area is, well, pretty much punctuated by us running away from a dude with a giant gun emplacement. Ow, ow, ow! You hit like a motherfucker, ow! You have to be very careful about him. He will chew through your health like you wouldn't believe. He also has some very nasty traps set up around here. Yay, more Bloodstone shards. I need a bunch of these. Oh god, is this room. Yeah, you see those urns sitting around there? Those are filled with, like, explosive oils. So do not just go in here. You run through. Oh god, that's a lot more crows than I thought. Nailed it. So yeah, I have a death in that room. Well, a couple deaths actually, as I try to figure out the best. Whoa, okay. There's three of you in here. Ow, ow. Oh wait, crap. Well, so much for that plan. I was actually planning on trying to lure them back through that building to the opposite side because I thought he had actually blown up all of the urns in that area. I was wrong. Now you all get to see my corpse running skills. No, no, wait. There it is. He doesn't have any new dialogue for us if we come back like this. I shouldn't have that many still running after me. Oh, dang it, I thought I'd kill him with that. Oh. And more antidotes and blood vials. Always handy. And now for this dick of a room. Kind of wish there was a way to, like, free aim your guns, and oh. Looks like a patient even decided to follow me. There is another way to kind of disarm the bombs by basically rolling through them. Like this. Oh crap, that was way too close, that was way too close. Now to figure out who has my blood echoes. In general, the goblin... Oh, hey, it's down to that crow. In general, the gremlin-looking dudes really don't do that much damage. The main issue with fighting them is that they're always in a fairly decently sized group. And we've always got Sir Shoots a lot pointing his gun at us throughout this area. Or I forget... Oh, damn it! I thought I'd roll through that. That was my bad. It's not very often that you can say, I missed my roll. Okay. Now let's try this again, first by killing you. Quickly followed by you. You're gonna burst out of there. I'm right back where I died. Bludgeon gemstone. As I recall, those ones up my... well, my gun damage. Okay, now where... there he is. He's up there. Yep. Alright, best ability to handle this area is just plain not to fight in it. And bam, we're now in his range shadow and can easily fend these guys off. And you swung way wide there, man. I was hoping to catch you and your buddies together, but you just had to separate from the group like that. And now we get to go and confront our gun buddy. Now there's actually a... well, normally you have to fight him, and he's actually a fairly hard fight. He's wielding the pile bunker, and I think he has the cannon. Can't recall. But there is actually a very easy way to handle him, as you will soon see. Actually, see him! Start shooting! Damn it! Okay, I fucked up.
I should think you still have Creed.
Damn it.
Well, the next time you dream, give some thought.
I shouldn't have dodged forward to get closer. Gave him time to actually get out of the hit stun. So yeah, there's another hunter to fight around here who wields the... I think he wields the pistol and the saw spear. As a fighter, he's not that bad, but he does have a lot of health, so it takes a while to get through him. Okay, let's see if I can do the trick properly this time. And I wish I knew where all my blood echoes were. Kind of like those back. It's probably, yeah, it's right here. Damn it! I don't know why he isn't flinching properly there. Son of a bitch! What's wrong with this?
Well, the next time you dream, give some thought.
Alright, we're back. Now this time, hopefully I won't fat thumb my L1 instead of my L2 so I can actually start properly shooting the bastard. Because I swear, this is how I've killed him several times. Hell, last time I did it on the first try, so I don't know why I'm having this much trouble with him. Come on, there we go! So yes, that is the easy way to kill him. You just push him off a building. Now, he actually drops something very important, but, well, as you might notice, he fell off. So how do we get his drop? Well, we just go to systems, exit the game, and load back in. And we're back, and his drop has appeared right here. The Powder Keg Hunter Badge. As you might imagine from its name, it gives us a whole bunch of gunpowder-based weaponry. One of which we can actually find right down here. And I will confess, first time I played through the game, I didn't get the Powder Keg Badge. Mainly because, well, I did not kill him. I managed to just run through this area, went down here and found the boss, and I just completely forgot about that dude's existence afterwards. I also did not know about this little, well, hidden area behind... as I recall, the rifle spear's around here. I might be wrong. Lord knows I am a very fallible human being who makes plenty of mistakes. Hell, I've already had more deaths in this one episode than I did against the last two bosses. One of them was friggin' Father Gascon. Okay, and... stick the landing. Well, that was a scream. That actually leads back to the normal progression through this area, but... there we go. Flying leap! Bloody messenger head bandage. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I probably missed the rifle spear back in that little pathway I fought the patient at. And crap. I will admit, normally I clear this area out before I try to come up here, because there are a bunch of gremlins and patients down there. Oh boy. I am in a very bad position. And I'm probably gonna die. Well, thank you, Cage Thing. That's one down. Let's see if I can nail any others. Oh my, yeah, they're pissed. A whole lot of them are pissed. There's like 10 enemies down here. The normal way it happens is I usually go up, there's like a balcony on the other side that you can come out and take a look at this area from. I usually go out there, one of them notices me, and then they all just pour in through the hallway nearby. And it's usually pretty darn intense. Trying to see if I can get any good angles, or... Can I? Why aren't you letting me lock on to other things? Oh, well, that'll work. Oh, that was a one molly kill. I don't care if you want to call this cheap. Those dudes hurt. Especially when all of them were to try to wail on me. There we go! That was the money shot! Okay, I'm gonna try to roll off the back here. Yep, knew that was gonna happen. There we go. There we go! A whole bunch of Molotovs later, and I survive. And we get Ritual Blood 1, which is actually very important for basically the reward for going all through here. Sup, dude? Yeah, I don't think so. Scream in my face some more, I'm sure that'll help you out. I guess, technically, I bought my Chief Hunter's emblem a bit prematurely since... Well, my soul... Well, blood echoes. Son of a bitch. Gonna constantly get that flipped out through this whole LP, aren't I? Anyway, I've already got 12,000 blood echoes at the moment. And hi there. And you're probably not alone. No, wait, you are alone. Thank you. So yeah, normally I usually come in... Oh hey, there's another drop over there. Anyway, I usually come in like right here. The one over by the altar spots me. It's enrages all the other ones near it. And then they all just start packing in like a clown car up the stairs. And all of you are huge. Okay, I didn't activate that one. Hey, dodging is my thing, not yours. Man, that didn't even take you out. I really need to start going upgrading my cleaver at some point. Lord knows I need to before I fight the boss, because this boss we're heading towards is a bitch. I guess technically that will be left for next episode, but whoa, wait. Okay, you are dead. Probably the one I knocked down from above. This probably, yep. Let me drop down here and... Down here. There we go. Now, I could have sworn the white rifle spear was around here. This is going to bug the ever-loving crap out of me all day until I actually find it, aren't I? I'll do one quick run through the secret passage again up here, and then we'll just continue on. Don't want to completely waste you people's times. But just let me satisfy my curiosity, please. I can't take it if I don't. And something went and died off camera. I don't know. It always weirds me out when that happens. Now, as I recall, you gotta jump down here. And this is just the hallway we were in earlier. Dang it. Well, I can still buy it from the shop now with the powder keg. And my health is low. Better blood vial up. And you all probably couldn't hear it, but my dog just gave me a very disapproving growl. Well, not growl, more like a whine. I guess he didn't like that second blood vial usage to top off my health. But blood vials are fairly cheap. My life is not. My life is currently worth 13,000. And my phone just started buzzing at me, so I have to reject it. Sup, Chris? There's five. Holy crap. Yeah, you flap around like that. You crows ain't got shit on me. I would also prefer it if you did not shit on me, so no perching above my hat, okay? That would be a rather nasty attack for them to give the crows. Be kind of hilarious, but still, ew. Hey, topped off my blood vials. And we now have a shortcut back to here. But let's just go down the ladder now. Okay. Yeah, where were the proper stairs down? Nope, not that way. Son of a bitch, why don't I remember this area better? Admittedly, it is kind of forgettable and very short. But still, you think I'd remember where the friggin' downstairs are. Son of a bitch! What the hell? Did I go completely wrong way? Am I stupid? Yes, I'm stupid. It's right here. It blends in with the background, I swear! This is getting smoky. Oh! Ow! Yeah, they just love having one of the gremlins do hiding in smoke. Thankfully, gremlins really don't require special tactics. They're pretty stupid, they charge at you, and they flinch easily, even from light weaponry hits. And oh god, it's this plaza. What's up, werewolf? Come at me, bro. Come on, come at me, bro. Come at me! Can't touch this! Oh good, I did it in time. Because, yeah, as you might notice, there's two in this area. Ow. Hey, Bloodstone Shards. And another Bloodstone Shard. Sweet. Might actually be able to just straight up plus three my Saw Cleaver. Oh, yes, this entrance. Yeah, it does not open from this side. This is actually kind of a alternate way you can handle the sniper dude we killed a second ago. Basically, it kind of requires just going through this entire area, making sure you don't kill him up there. And then, well, not long after that, we can get access to the area that leads to the boss over there. Kill him, we open that door so we can actually approach him from behind and sneak up on him. And then he says, hey, don't go messing with these people and we're cool. And then we say, alright. And then he gives us the powder keg, Penta Hunter keg, whatever, the badge. And that's on like no one cares. Ooh, beast blood pellets! Oh crap, I forgot about you. Guess I could recover my health from wailing on you like that. Ah, dang it. Oh well, more Blood Sun Shard. The dude actually has a kind of an interesting backstory that's heavily tied with this whole area. Basically, what happened in Old Yharnam is, well, kind of what's happening in... Whoa! Dang it. That was back far enough that he wouldn't nail me with that, but whatever. Anyway, what happened to Old Yharnam is basically what's happening now in Central Yharnam. Except they couldn't contain it nearly as well. There was like a disease going on around here. And basically, to cure the disease, they tried to their whole blood ministration shit on them. People did not react to it well. And then they started turning into, whoa. Well, what you're looking at here, the werewolves and the gremlin dudes. Okay. Alright. And after, well, things kept on getting shittier and shittier, they just sealed the entire area off like you saw with the big gate. And then just left everything alone. And the dude we just killed up there was basically part of the hunter force that tried to help clear this place out. Obviously they failed. He took it very personally and decided to dedicate his life to, I don't know how to put it, protect this area. Try to keep these people safe, I guess. I don't know. Either way, he's dead now. And now that I think about it, I don't think I talked about fire paper last time I picked some up. Basically, it acts like a weapon buff. I use it, it makes my saw cleaver go all flamey. It's very handy. Especially since most beast type enemies are pretty weak to, well, fire. Oh. The fuck was that? I see nothing. Oh, there you are. Well, you aren't the one making that noise, apparently. Actually, that's probably the boss of the area making that noise now that I'm thinking about it. You guys are tanky. You're also dead. And more Bloodstone Shards. Sweet. Hopefully I'll be able to plus up my favorite weapon in a little bit. And yes, I'm scanning all my angles as much as I can. Oh, were you the one that was freaking out a second ago? Ah, dang it. I thought I would just open it up. I didn't want to do my full transformation strike. What? Son of a bitch. Well, that's my first poisoning. Didn't think I'd actually have to use one of these already. Oh, hey. Apparently my dude was just going, "What up?" Hey, hey, more Bold Hunter's Marks. I'm actually going to have to use one in a little bit. Because we're actually very close to the boss, and as I said, you don't want to fight this boss unless you've upgraded a little bit. Especially since we're carrying almost 20,000 souls. Oh, yes, and since we've met Alfred, I can actually summon him to help us out with bosses. I really wouldn't call him necessary for the one we're about to fight. But it is one of those nice little touches that... Whoa! But there are definitely fights where it's handy to have someone around to help you out. And if for nothing else, then to just get the boss to look at him for a few seconds for you to go heal. Honestly, when I have summoned someone, that's usually what I'm using him for. And stop celebrating! You have nothing to celebrate about at the moment. Oh, there you are. I can't even kill these guys in one full combo. I really do need some upgrades. Alright, and that's this whole area clear. And so, time to warp back and do some housekeeping. And we're back, and the doll's gone. Where'd she go? Well, first, let's show off what we just unlocked in the shop. We got the rope Molotov cocktail, which explodes behind you. Honestly, I've never found that many uses for it. So, yeah, don't expect to see me use them. Now, of course, the weaponry is what we want to see. You can buy the rifle spear, which, as you can see, is a spear. But when you activate its trick mode, it becomes a rifle. Duh. So it's nice for blood tinge and skill-ish builds, as I recall. Whoops. That's not what I wanted to do, game. And the other weapon it gets is the stake driver. Which is kind of a fun weapon, but it's a bit too short range for my taste. And like I said, it can do a lot of damage, but it's very melee. As I recall, it has arcane descaling? Huh. Never really noticed that, but still. It also requires 18 strength to wield. Oh, there she is. She's hanging out at this grave. Kind of wondering who it is, or maybe I just don't want to know. Stop celebrating! And I have plenty of shards. Holy crap. So, yes, our weapon is now doing much better now. As you can see, generally get a 9 to my base damage and then a plus 2 to the scalings. But unfortunately, we can't do it anymore because I... See, where does it say? Oh, yeah, upper right. Twin Bloodstone shards are now required. And now we can... Oh. Should probably... Oh, I guess I don't need to repair it, huh? You'd think it would actually need to be repaired by this point, but whatever. So at this point, I have a tempering blood gemstone, which ups my physical attack by 0.7%. Riveting, I know, isn't it? The other one ups my blunt damage, but this one is not a, well, blunt weapon. As I recall, you do need to plus up a weapon at least once in order to be able to put a bloodstone into it. So yeah, our blood tinge one, blood attack up by 1.8%. I am just overwhelmed by these options, holy crap. Obviously they do get better later, but still it is fairly underwhelming the first time you come here and take a look at that and go, I'm not doing much with these, aren't I? Also, over here, we have some new stuff in this place. We can actually get the Ashen Hunter set, which is what we get unlocked from killing our buddy up on the clock tower. It's Jura, that was his name. It's his set. Jura is known for his contact with the powder kegs, the heretics of the workshop. He's said to have been both uncommonly kind and dreadfully foolish. Jura felt defeated by the state of Old Yharnam and renounced his hunter's vows. Kind of what I said earlier. And this is kind of the ways that you can try and find out some of the backstories of some of the characters. This one does not look all that different from the other one, other than it's painted with ash in a ceremony to ward off blood. They all say the same. Oh, and apparently the wolf cap is his trademark. We also have Gascon's set. The dingy scarf is a holy shawl and symbol of the healing church from which Gascon would eventually part ways. Father is a title used for clerics in a foreign land, and there is no such rank in the healing church. I actually do like Gascon's garb. It's a pretty decent set. I mean, it's got several hundreds all across the board, and it costs 3 insight to get. As you might notice, the items are actually fairly cheap. So at this point, I'm actually going to buy it. But now that we're done with all that, well, we might as well talk to him. Dang it, stop celebrating!
Even for hunters. A workshop where hunters used blood to enhance their weapons and flesh. We don't have as many tools as we once did, but you're welcome to use whatever you find.
Well, thankfully, I've actually found one of them.
Should it please you?
Oh, that was a creepy statement. Pretty sure that can be taken a very wrong way, dude.
What is it you desire?
Channel my blood echoes.
Let me.
Alright, let's get a couple more points into vitality for more health. Because Lord knows we need more health. And let's actually pump up endurance a bit. Endurance is actually a very important stat since, well, it governs stamina. But you don't need as much of it as you would think, like you would in Dark Souls. About 30 is where I usually keep it at times, because that lets me do my full combo and dodge out, usually. And while we're at it, might as well give a point to our strength to actually get some buffing done there. So our stats are starting to look quite a bit better than they were before. And we're poor again! Yay! That means I can actually fight bosses without worry of, well, losing a crap ton of echoes! Son of a bitch! Echoes! Anyway, so that was Old Yharnam. Join me next time as we killed the blood-hungry beast. I think that's its name. Son of a bitch.